Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. We were called out to this home in Prior Lake, Minnesota to replace a radon fan because the customer noticed that their YouTube gauge was reading zero. So both fluid levels were equal at zero, indicating that there was a problem with the radon system. So it ended up being something really simple. So make sure you stay tuned to the end to find out what to check before you call your radon mitigation contractor. So in this video, we're going to talk about your two options when you when it's time to replace your radon fan. You can do a simple fan swap, so just take the dead fan out, replace it with the equivalent fan, or you can bring everything up to current code and do what's called system optimization. So I will show you some of the things that I personally would recommend if this was my house, and I've recommended them to the customer. In this instance, they may be selling the house in a couple years. They opted just to get the system back up and running. They're going to retest, make sure that the radon levels are indeed low, because they never did test after they had the system installed, and then they can go take those final steps if they do want to make the system more energy efficient and effective. But I'll show you how to do that in this video. So the first thing I would recommend to them is to do some sealing, because a radon system works by creating suction underneath the home. And here we've got some cracks that could be sealed. So we've got a poured foundation. You can see where the contractor sealed this crack here. And then they've got this 6 mil poly that is against the poured wall. And you can see the crack here, or a pretty significant gap. So we know we're losing conditioned air, air being drawn from the house that they're paying to heat and cool down these cracks and openings. So here's where the water line comes up through the floor. So I would definitely recommend sealing these things to make the system more energy efficient. So if we go out of the mechanical room here, there's also a big one that should be sealed. Showers with a fiberglass tub like this often have a plumbing block out underneath, and that's where the plumber has room to hook up their drain. So I'll show you what that looks like. So that's where the plumbing comes through the floor for the bathtub drain, and you can see the rock there, and the concrete is not poured up tight to that. So I would recommend foaming that to seal it up and make it more energy efficient. So another thing to mention when we're talking about system optimization is they've got new ECE radon fans out, and it's got a potentiometer, which means there's a dial in there. So we can dial that fan into exactly the settings we need. So we always talk about in our videos, the key to getting your radon levels low is to create a system that has or creates vacuum or suction under the entire floor. So we do that by a process called pressure field extension. So what's involved with it is we'll have a couple of holes that we drill through the floor, half inch holes. We hook a gauge called a micromanometer up to it, and it allows us to measure the amount of suction that the radon fan is creating. And then we can dial everything in, so it's not oversized and it's not undersized. We want to balance radon reduction with energy efficiency. So in this house, the radon suction point is in the mechanical room back there. So the areas that are going to be hardest to reach are their son's room. So I would recommend a test hole in there. And then they've also got a bedroom over here. We've got that bathroom, and this is probably going to be one of the harder areas to reach. So what we do when we're measuring pressure field extension is we would simply pull up the corner of this carpet, and then I would drill a half inch hole through the floor and then hook my gauge up, take my readings with the micromanometer, and then when we're done with that, we can put this carpet back, and we'd also fill that hole. But we got a carpet stretcher, so I know that scares a lot of people, but you would never know this, that this test hole is here. All right, so now we're out in the garage. We've got the radon pipe where it comes out of the mechanical room behind those cabinets there, and then it runs up behind the TV and it goes into the garage attic. You'll see the pipe behind the TV, and then we've got the red fire stop collar, so I'm glad they have that, but I would love to see insulation on that pipe. So now I'll show you what's up in the attic and see what the simple fix was. All right, so now I'm up in the garage attic. You'll see this is where the pipe comes up right there. And then it runs along the trusses here. I would love to see insulation on this pipe, as it's now required by code. So that was one of my recommendations to the homeowner. Another thing to point out is you'll see my level here. The pipe pitches back to the fan here. So we're gonna get a little bit of tiny little bit of water that's trapped in the pipe that can't run back to the sub pit like it's supposed to. But not a huge deal, but we would recommend fixing the pitch on that. So I came here to replace the radon fan. So I came up here right away to see what kind of fan I had to swap it out with. And I saw this red light was on. I hit the reset button and boom, our fan's back up. So quick tip, if you are experiencing a radon fan failure or you think you are, check the GFCI. We're not really sure what caused this to trip. Maybe it's an electrical issue or possibly something with the fan, but they're gonna keep an eye on it and monitor. They are gonna do another radon test to ensure that their radon levels are indeed low. If they do come back higher than they're comfortable with, then they'll have us come back, do the system optimization, and do the sealing that we talked about. In conclusion, you've got a few options to think about when it's time to replace your radon fan. You can simply swap it out for an equivalent model. You can bring everything up to current radon standards, or you can do the system optimization so we make sure that your radon system is both energy efficient and effective to keep you and your family safe. If you enjoyed this video, please consider liking and subscribing. It does help out a lot with the YouTube algorithm, and we are forever grateful. I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thank you so much for watching.